G'day. On the occasion of my 200th YouTube subscriber, good on you, Jared. I just wanted to share with you a little bit from The Plains by Jared Manane that I'm reading at the moment. It's got this lovely description of, you know, what it is to be a composer out here in regional Australia, I think. So I'll just share this little excerpt. A composer explained that all his tone poems and symphonic sketches had been conceived and written within a few miles of his birthplace, in one of the least populous quarters of the plains. He was trying to find the musical equivalent of the characteristic sound of his district. Strangers commented on the utter silence of the place, but the composer spoke of a subtle blend of sounds that most people habitually failed to hear. When his music was performed, the members of the orchestra were stationed far apart among the audience. Each instrument produced a volume of sound that could be heard only by the few listeners nearest it. The audience was free to move around as quietly or as noisily as they wished. Some were able to hear snatches of melody as subtle as the scraping together of grass blades or the throbbing of the brittle tissue of insects. A few even found some spot from which more than one instrument was audible. Most heard no music at all. Critics objected that no one from the audience or the orchestra could hope to hear whatever harmony might have resulted from themes that were barely stated. The composer had always maintained in public that this was just as he intended, that the purpose of his art was to draw attention to the impossibility of comprehending even such an obvious property of a plane as the sound that came from it. But in private, and especially in the hotel where I spent the last hours before my journey, the composer regretted that he would never know what his works amounted to. During each rehearsal, he wandered all over the almost empty hall, hoping, quite unreasonably he knew, to hear from somewhere a hint of the whole whose separate parts he knew so well, but he was seldom aware of any more than the trembling of a single reed or string, and he almost envied those who heard the play of the wind across miles of grass as no more than a tantalizing silence. And to me, that really does speak about how it is to be surrounded by the beauty of the Australian landscape and to find inspiration in it and yet feel somehow thwarted when looking for ways to express musically what one hears. So yeah, thanks for sharing and keep watching. Cheers.